Listen very carefully. I am going to explain the resolution of vector into components. Right? First, I am going to explain in 2D how we can resolve the vector into components in 2 dimension. For the purpose, let us see here 2 dimension we can take. This is the x axis and this is the y axis. Okay? And let us take one vector, right? Let us take one vector that is a bar. Vector a bar is like this. This is a vector. Vector a bar, this one, right? Its length is the a. The vector can be indicated with an arrow. Vector can be indicated with an arrow. The arrow line segment length gives the magnitude, right? This length gives the magnitude and head shows the direction. The vector can be indicated graphically by using arrow, right? And the arrow length gives the magnitude, head shows the direction. Like this, here a bar is the vector, its magnitude is a, right? Length is a, and it is making some angle with x axis that we can take as theta. Now I am going to resolve this into components. For that, let us take some component along the x axis. That component I will take as ax. Ax is the one component that is along the x axis. Ax is the component along the x axis. That is, we write as ax I cap, right? But its length is ax. Its length is ax. And I am going to resolve one more component that is along the y axis, that is ay. Ax and Ay. I am going to divide the vector A into components, that is along the x axis and along the y axis. Along the x axis component is Ax, along the y axis component is Ay. A bar is a vector. A bar is a vector. A bar is a vector making theta angle with the positive x axis. Okay, right? Now what I am telling it here, right? I am resolving the vector into components. One component along the x axis, that I am considering as ax, and other component is along the y axis. Okay, I will take one triangle at here, O P Q triangle we can take. According to this triangle, we write one thing, that Ax is the component along the x axis. That's why we can write as from figure we write one thing, that is one vector we can take as along the OP and other vector along the PQ we can take. Ax is the component along the x axis. That's why we can write as this is Ax I cap, and this will also become Ay from the figure. Is it right? When this is Ay and this is also Ay, then we can write here from the figure A bar is equal to, like this we can write OP bar, OP bar, this is OP bar, this is OQ bar, OP bar plus OQ bar, sorry, OP bar plus PQ bar is equal to OQ bar, we can write according to the triangle. Look at here, one vector this one and other vector is this one, then the resultant is this one. You see OP and PQ are the two sides of triangle, then the OQ is the third side. Then OQ equal to OP plus OQ, right? OQ bar is what? Here OP is the AX vector form, if you want to write. I cap we should write because it is along the X axis. PQ is along the Y axis. That's all we write as AY J cap. OQ is the vector, that is A bar. We write the general form of vector in 2 dimension, that it has only 2 components, that is AX I cap plus AY J cap. This is the vector indication in 2 dimension, because in 2 dimension only 2 components are there. One is x component, other one is y component. Okay, you see, once again I will explain the another format. For example, this is a toy car. You see here, this is a toy car. When the toy car is pulled by a boy by using a thread with some force F. Now let us see that force is resolved into components. you see that force is making some angle, that is theta. Okay, right. Now when toy car is pulled with a rope, with a thread, at that moment what happens? Any. Okay. Okay, vector is the force we are applying, that one, that is along the x-axis, angle made is theta. Okay. Now, how the toy car will move forward? The toy car will move on the road, right? Toy car will be move on the road, but while going, the front part of the toy car will be raises like this. Front part of the toy car will be raises and goes forward with the back wheels. Is it correct, students? Toy car, that one. Right, the toy car goes forward, but it will go with the right back wheels when somebody is pulled with certain angle. Right, in this, the force can be used in two ways. That sum of the force is used to move the toy car. Okay, that is the component along the x-axis. Force, some part used to move the car, force, some part used to lift the car. That means if F force is acting this side, in that part of force acts along the x-axis, part of force will act along the y-axis. Like that, F is a vector, it has the two components, that is Fx and Fy. Like that, A bar is a vector, A is its magnitude, it is also have two components, one is along the x-axis Ax and along the y-axis Ay. By using formula we write like this. Is it clear how we can resolve the vector into components? Not understood or understood? You see, the toy car, you can take the example, force I am applying this side, force I am applying this side, but the toy car is moving forward on the road. That means sum of the force used to move the car, that is the part of force, that is Fx, that is x along the x-axis. Sum of the force used to lift the car, front part of the lift car is lifted upward. This is a toy car, toy means children can play with that, right? And for that, just toy car, he took one child took the toy car and he connected one thread and he is pulling the thread and going forward. At that moment, the toy car will goes forward with the back wheels. In this, front part of the toy car will be lifted upward. For that, some force is used, and for the moving of the car, some force is used. That means the applied force is divided into two components. One is along the x-axis and other is along the y-axis. Similarly, any vector can be split into two parts. This is a vector A, right, its magnitude, and A bar is a vector, its magnitude is A. It can be split into two components. One component is along the x-axis and other component is along the y-axis, that is in two dimension. Clear, students? Understood or not understood? Tell me fast. If you have doubt, you can tell. If you have doubt, you can ask me. So we have to find out the component value now. Now from triangle OPQ, we write the sin theta formula. Sin theta, what we write? Sin theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side we write. Is it correct? Sin theta opposite side is what? Sin theta matlab opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side what? AY. Hypotenuse is what? A. Is it correct? And then AY formula, what you will get? AY is equal to A sin theta. Then similarly, cos theta formula, what we write? Cos theta equal to, in this triangle OPQ, adjacent side by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is what? AX. AX, hypotenuse A. Then AX is equal to, we will get as A cos theta. A cos theta. Right? Now, from this, we can write the component of vector along the x-axis. Component of vector A bar along x-axis. What is that? What is that? Ax. Its formula is what? A cos theta. Component of vector along the x-axis, A cos theta. And component of vector, component of vector a bar, component of vector a bar along y axis. Can you tell what is that? A y, that is equal to a sin theta. If you add both the vectors, both the components, you will get the original value. Original vector is a bar, right? A is magnitude of a bar. A is the magnitude of a bar, right? Students, if you have any query, you can ask me immediately, and don't say after completion of whole topic once again explain not understood anything. That words you should, I should not listen. You should not say. That's all. Okay, now I want to divide these two equations. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. When you divide these two equations, equation 2 by equation 1, if you will do, we will get the tan theta, right? Sin theta by cos theta. A sin theta by A cos theta is equal to, okay, equation 2 by equation 1, if you will do, you will get as AY by AX. That is nothing but tan theta is equal to AY by AX. What is theta in this? Can anyone tell what is theta? Huh? Theta is what? Angle made by the vector a bar with what? With x axis. Is it correct? Right. In the exam, they may ask, for example, like this, they will ask the question. One problem I will explain, you may understood by using that problem, right? And force of 12 newton applied on a toy car at an angle 60 degree with the horizontal as shown in figure. Find the horizontal and vertical components of force. Components of force. This is the question. Right? Let us see here in the diagram they gave like this. In the diagram they gave like this. This force is 12 newtons. This is making 60 degree angle with the horizontal. This is the horizontal. This is horizontal. Right? With the horizontal, it is making 60 degree angle. Right? 60 degree angle. Then question is what? The question is what? Tell me. We should find out the horizontal component and vertical component. Horizontal means what? Horizontal means along the x axis. Okay. Vertical means along the y axis. You see here it was very simple. That is the I am going to explain the solution. For that, write the given values. Force they gave 12 newtons and the force making 60 degree with the angle x axis. You see here this is the x axis and this is the y axis. Okay, and that on the tie car they are applying the force like this. That force value is 12 newtons and that force is making 60 degree with the horizontal. Horizontal means x axis. They are asking the horizontal component and vertical component. Horizontal component means component along the x axis. Horizontal component. Component along the x axis. This is the vertical horizontal component we can take as fx. Vertical component is Fy. Force one component. Force divided into two parts. One part is the horizontal and other part is the vertical. Right? Then they are asking the horizontal component Fx and vertical component Fy. Right? Horizontal and vertical components. Horizontal component. What is the horizontal component of force? Means component along the x-axis. Component along x-axis. What is the Fx na? Fx formula is what? Tell me. F cos theta. Right? F into F is 2L. Cos theta is what? Cos 60 V. Right? What is the value of cos 60? Anybody knows? 1 by 2. Means Fx is 6 newtons. Vertical component is what? Vertical component. What is the formula for the vertical component? Vertical component is what? What is the formula for the vertical component? There is a component along the y-axis. Along the y-axis. F sin theta. From where you learned these components? Just now I said. There is a component of along the x-axis means a cos theta. Along the y-axis, a sin theta. Where we took the vector is a bar and magnitude is a. A magnitude divided into components ax and ay. That is ax is a cos theta, ay is a sin theta. Here f is the magnitude. Right, that is the force magnitude that divided into two components, right? That is along the x-axis and along the y-axis. Then along the y-axis formula is f sin theta, f is 2l sin 60, right? What is the value of sin 60? Tell me fast. Root 3 by 2. Then what you are getting it here? 6 root 3 newtons. Is it correct? Yes or no? This is like this, we can divide the vector into components. Like this, we can divide the vector into components. Let us see one more example. Example 2 is that, right? Horizontal and vertical components of a force is horizontal and vertical component of force is 3 newton and 4 newton. Find the net force and its direction. Right? They gave the horizontal and vertical components. We have to find out the net force and direction also. Then what we have to do it here? For example, horizontal component they gave. This is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. For example, this is the force direction. And horizontal component means Fx. Vertical component means Fy, right? They gave the Fx and Fy. They are asking to find out the direction of the force, total force, right? Total force is theta. Sorry, total force is F. This is Fx and this is Fy, and this one also become Fy. What we are doing it here? Some force F is this one, and that is divided into two parts. Some part of the force is along the x-axis, part of the force along the y-axis. Right, and then we form a rectangle. This is Fy means this one also Fy. This is Fx means this one also Fx. This diagonal is the F, right? And this is Fy and this is Fx, right? And then here, how to find out the vector? Vector in terms of what they gave in the question, first we write. Right, anybody knows the answer for this? Fx is what? 3 Newton. Fy is what? 4 Newton. Force horizontal means along the x-axis. Along the x-axis force value they give. Along the y-axis component of the force they give. Force means, they are asking the net force and the direction also they are asking. How much angle net force makes. Then general vector form, if you want to write the force divided into components, we write component of vector of force along the x-axis Fx I cap we write. Fy j cap we write. If you want the magnitude of the force, we write magnitude like this. Magnitude formula is what? Either you can use the Pythagoras principle also it here. F is equal to what we can write? from the figure. Under root fx square plus fy square we write. Is it correct? I want the resultant force, net force. Net force formula is under root fx square plus fy square. That is the 3 square plus 4 square. Is it correct? Right. Then next, 3 square is what? 9. 4 square 16. 9 plus 16 25. Then we are getting the 5 newton. This is the resultant force. How much angle it will makes? Tan theta formula is what? Opposite side by hypotenuse. Right. Fy by fx. That is a 4 by 3. Then what you will get the theta? Theta is equal to tan inverse 4 by 3. Clear, Babu? Any doubt? Is it clear or not? Okay, if here what they give? They give the total force value and angle. Force angle if they give, we find out the components. And in the next case, they give the components, we find out the force and angle. In the previous problem, they gave the force and angle. We find out the components. And in this problem, they gave the components, we find out the total force. Right? Next. Are you writing the notes? Okay, let us go for the next one. Next one is the resolution of vector in 3D. Resolution of vector in 3D. Resolution of vector in 3D. Actually, we are dividing the vector into components means, just simply for example, you have a chalk piece that you divide, that you split into two parts. Okay, for example, I have a chalk piece that I split it into two parts. Then we have the two parts. When you combine the two parts, you will get the total. Right? When you split any vector into components, only components will present, the vector will disappear. Right? When you combine the vector components, two components, again vector you will get. Okay. Right? Then the result, splitting of vector into components. I mean just dividing into parts. Okay. Right. When you divide the book into parts, you will get the papers. When you combine the papers, you will get the notebook. Right, like that. Dividing the book into components means papers. When you combine the papers, then you will get the total book. Right, resolution of vector in 3D. Very, very important topic. In total education, you will use this one. Not only in 11th, not only in 12th. Right, now we will go for the 3D. 3D. This is the 3D along the x-axis. This is the y-axis. This is the z-axis. Now in 3D, we will take one vector. This is the A bar. This vector is making alpha angle with the x-axis and beta angle with y-axis and gamma angle with the z-axis. Okay. Alpha, beta, gamma are angles made by vector A bar with the x comma y and z axis respectively. Okay, got it? Then let us go for the vector form. How to write the vector A? For example, it has many components. 3D means three components will be there. A bar x component is, we can take ax, y component is ay, z component we take as az. Let us see, this we can write as x component ax, y component ay, z component az. We write in the general form, that is a bar is equal to ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap. If you want its magnitude of vector a bar formula is what? Magnitude of a bar is a. Right now, can you tell the A formula, students? Under root AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. What are AX, AY, AZ? Here the three components are there. because it is the three dimension, right? I want the formula for x component. Component of vector along A bar. Component of vector along A bar. Sorry. Component of vector A bar along x axis. What is that? Can you tell? Ax na? Iska formula A cos alpha. You remember it. And component of vector along vector A bar, component of vector A bar along y axis I want. Along y axis. Its formula is A cos beta, which you should take the angle with y axis. And component of vector along component of vector A bar along z axis. That formula is A cos gamma. Right? And if you write the cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma formula from this, cos alpha is equal to what you will get? Ax by A. Cos beta is equal to what? Ay by A. Cos gamma is equal to what? Az by A. This cos alpha, comma cos beta and cos gamma are called as directional cosines. They are called as directional cosines. Their name is there. Directional cosines. They are called as directional cosines. If you find out why they are called as directional cosines, they will indicate the direction of the vector. Vector A bar is making alpha angle with the x axis, means giving the direction, and beta angle is giving the direction of A bar, gamma angle is giving the direction of A bar. That means this alpha, beta, gamma shows the directions, and their cosines are the cos alpha, cos gamma, cos beta, right? That means they are said to be directional cosines. If you find out the cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma, what you will get? That is ax square by a square plus ay square by a square plus az square by a square. Right? In the denominator you can common, that is a square, you will get as ax square plus ay square plus az square you will get. Then next, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to, we will get as this one is we know a formula under root ax square plus ay square plus az square. Then if you write the formula, that is ax square plus ay square plus az square, it will be there. In the denominator a square is there. A square formula, what you will get? Same ax square plus ay square plus az square you will get. They will be cancelled with each other. Finally, what you will get? This relation, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equal to, you will get as 1. Is it correct, students? Yes or no? If you write this one, 1 minus sin square alpha plus 1 minus sin square beta, you know, cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta, 1 minus sin square beta plus 1 minus sin square gamma, you will get 1. If you simplify it, you will get the sin square alpha plus sin square beta plus sin square gamma, you will get as, what you will get? 2. Right? Okay, once again, you can, you write the notes, after that you read it, then you will get everything. Okay, A bar is a vector, it is making alpha angle with the x axis and beta angle with the y axis. You see, blue line is the vector, it is making alpha angle with x axis, beta with y axis, gamma with z axis. Then three components are there. Then one is x component, its formula is a cos alpha, y component b, a cos beta, z component a cos gamma. From this equation, cos alpha we wrote. You see, ax equal to a cos alpha, a to x to left side, then cos alpha equal to x by a you will get. Cos beta, a y by cos beta, from this you will get. You follow the cursor. Ay equal to a cos beta and cos beta equal to ay by a. Cos gamma equal to from this equation az equal to a cos gamma. Cos gamma formula greater than az by a. Then squaring on both sides and add all of them and finally you will get the one and change the cos square alpha into sin square by converting by using trigonometric equation, right? And then after that finally you will get this one. Okay, this is the topic and this topic is very very important and try to revise today itself. Okay, and maintain the notes and today talk class I am going to close. Thank you to all.